this is Johnny Bones, a local character here in Tombstone, stands out here and dances and plays the bone. Express building is now Doc Holliday's saloon. In history, Doc Holliday did have a saloon, but unfortunately it was in Las Vegas, New Mexico. It wasn't in Tombstone. One time they had 104 saloons in this town. On October 28, 1880, Curly Bill Brewster shot Marshal Fred White right here in this corner. And actually wired up, went to court and testified for Curly Bill, saying it was probably an accident. He didn't go to kill him. On January the 4th, 1881, Michael O'Rourke killed Henry Snyder down in Charleston, Arizona, about 8 or 9 miles south of here. Marshall was afraid that we were going to lynch him, so they brought him over here to Tombstone, wired up in the town marshal, locked up Michael O'Rourke in the Vogan's bowling alley here. Pretty soon a lynch mob formed to lynch him, and wide open the marshal kept him from getting a hold of Michael O'Rourke, who was known as Johnny Behind the Dukes. This is the OK Corral, where they had the big shootout. Actually, the shootout was behind this OK Corral in a vacant lot, a couple of doors down. October 26, 1881, the afternoon. Wide up, met up with Virgil and Morgan up here on this corner. They were joined by Doc Holliday. They walked straight down this street to the corner and took a left. In a few minutes was the gunfight at the OK Corral. And contrary to popular belief, they're going to probably walk down the sidewalk here. Since the street would have had about 4, 5, 6 inches of horse and cattle and mule poop, and no telling what else. Go down to the gunfight. So Wyatt and the brothers came up, walking up this street toward me. Went into this alley here next to Fly's photographic studio. That's where the gunfight commenced right here on the wall. In fact, Doc Holliday was out of the street here where he really started, when the shooting started. One of the cowboys. Crawled out here and died right here by this telephone pole.
Well, then I'll buy back, he can have it. Oh, I don't want that.
Wait, no!
Hotel. Here across the street was the site of the Cosmopolitan Hotel. After they shot Virgil and crippled him, the Earps moved all of their families into the Cosmopolitan Hotel. They thought it'd be a little bit easier to guard everybody there from getting hurt. It's a parking lot today, but back after the gunfight at the OK Corral, they used this building as a courthouse and a courtroom. This is where they brought the Earps up on trial for murdering the other cowboys at the OK Corral. This is the Oriental Saloon where Wyatt and his brothers had an interest in some of the gambling tables here. Where they have a gunfighting show inside the Oriental Saloon today. The building is original. Walked on the same floor as Wyatt walked on. But the December 28th, 1882, Virgil Hook came out of this front door of this Oriel Saloon and walked across the street. Across the street was the Crystal Palace. Someone over here in this building here that was under construction at the time fired a couple of shotguns and hit Virgil in the arm. He's not able to use the arm for the rest of his life. The building where they shot at Virgil was the Bloody Bucket Saloon. It was under construction at the time. Now it's the Longhorn Restaurant. March 18th, 1882. Morgan Earp was murdered here at Tamblyn Hatch's Billiards. Shot him in the back. Historic Bird Cage Theater in Ballroom and Saloon. House of Ill Repeat.
It's in the back, in the museum. You can look up, you'll see our 14 birdcage cribs. A crib is nothing more than a 4x8 cubicle. They are seven suspended from a ceiling on that side going back, seven on that side. They are connected here in the front by a catwalk. That is where the ladies would entertain for $25 a visit. And if you'd like to know how busy our ladies were, go to the end of that glass case, look up those steps, look at the top three or four stairs. They are worn down to the thickness of a silver dollar, done in less than 9 years. Underneath the weeds, we had gambling all the way down to the lower level. We still have our blackjack, faro, or dice table. The faro table does sit in its original position with the original chairs. That is where Doc Holliday would sit, deal, and play faro. As you go on up on our stage, you're going to see a lot of pictures of actors and actresses that did perform on our stage, such as Leah Russell, Richard Mansfield, Maude Adams, and Fatima, our belly dancer. She performed here in 1881 and in 1882 while in San Francisco. She had that painting done, had it sent here to the Birdcage as a thank you for jumpstarting her career. She did gain fame and fortune, come on in folks, and later became known as Little Egypt. As you go on around on our backstage, you are going to see one of Tombstone's most valuable antiques, known as the Black Mariah. The Black Mariah is our original Tombstone hearse, trimmed in 24 karat gold and sterling silver. There was only 8 of those ever made. That is the only one still known to be in existence today. Built in Rochester, New York by the Cunningham brothers. Then you'll go down a set of steps. That's going to take you downstairs to our poker room. That is where the West's longest poker game was played. Lasted 8 years, 5 months, 3 days nonstop. You might have to wait 2 or 3 days to hear your name called for a seat. Then it was $1,000 to enter that game. In today's money, 30 grand. So it did bring in all the big boys, people like Bat Masters, Diamond Jim Brady, George Randolph Hearst, the Hearst Fortune, and Mr. Adolphus Bush. Now, we do have two large bordello rooms downstairs. They are your full-size rooms, fully furnished. One of those rooms was occupied by that beautiful lady, that is Josephine Sarah Marcus. She worked here from 1881 to 1882. Her and wife did mate downstairs. She became his third wife. This is our, we had 16 gunfights, 26 people killed. They are over 140 bullet holes throughout the building. Now, this is a 45 caliber in the bar post, been in our 138 years, still in there today. Behind the door, the green wall, right above the lady between us, 44. The team, our belly dancer.
Back of the stage curtain, you can see the bullet hole a little better. Thank you. across the street from where I grew up. This house was owned by Pete Spence.